Today we have a very beautiful feast. We call it the Feast of the Immaculate Conception. So what does the word immaculate mean? Does anybody know? Immaculate. Stainless or pure. And the conception talks about when a child is growing in the womb of his mother. So do some of you have little baby brothers or sisters? So you know that they grew inside your mother for a time, right? So in this feast today, we celebrate that moment when Mary came to life in the womb of her mother. And in that moment, God did a very beautiful thing for her and gave her a great gift that I'm going to talk about in just a minute. But I want to talk about three phrases in today's gospel, because I think that they're important phrases for Mary, and they're important phrases for us as well. And all three of these phrases were spoken by the angel when he came to Mary. The first one is a part of her greeting. And the angel says, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you." That's a beautiful thing to think about, isn't it? That God is with us. And that's really what we're celebrating at Christmas time, the fact that God comes to be with us. And the angel wanted to remind Mary that no matter what happened in her life, no matter what situation she found herself in, that the Lord was always with you. And we say that, and we kind of remind ourselves of that at Mass, too. As you go through Mass today, listen to how many times I say, "The Lord be with you." That kind of reflects that greeting of that angel, doesn't it? So it's a reminder to each of us that the Lord is with us as well. The second phrase that I want to point out is that the angel says to Mary, "Do not be afraid." You can imagine how fearful Mary must have been or nervous when that angel appeared. And the angel came and he gave her this great greeting, and it says that she kind of wondered what this was all about. She didn't know the end of the story yet, so she was wondering what it meant that an angel was coming to her and greeting her in such a wonderful way. And so the angel wanted her to know that when God was working in her life, she didn't have anything to fear, because God always wanted good for her, and God always wants good for us. Now, sometimes we find ourselves in difficult or scary or challenging situations. But these greetings of the angel remind us that God is with us, and therefore, we do not need to be afraid. In fact, I read once somewhere that the phrase that we find most often in the Bible is, "Do not be afraid." So that's God's main message to us. Do not be afraid, for I am with you. And the third phrase that I want to point out is the one at the very end of the gospel. The angel has said that Mary's cousin, Elizabeth, is going to have a child as well. Now, Elizabeth was a pretty old woman at that point, and nobody thought she'd be able to have any children. And so God has given her this gift as well, and her child will be John the Baptist, who we're hearing about on Sundays. And so the angel says, God has done this great thing for her, because nothing is impossible with God. And sometimes we find that we're kind of stuck. We don't know how to get out of the situation that we're in. It seems like it's kind of overwhelming. It seems like there's no way out, that it'll never change. The angel reminded Mary and reminds us that nothing is impossible with God. Therefore, we don't have to fear, because the Lord is with us. So all three of those phrases come together in a very beautiful thing for us to remember. That God is always with us, always at work in our lives, and that we don't have to be afraid, because nothing is impossible with God. What was the gift that Mary received that we celebrate today? It was the gift that when she was conceived in the womb of her mother, does anybody know what the name of Mary's mother is? her mother's name was St. Anne. So when her mother and father, St. Anne and St. Joachim, were having Mary, God gave her the gift that at the very moment of the beginning of her life, at the very moment of her conception, she was kept free from sin, to prepare her to say yes to the invitation that the angel gives to her, to be the mother of God. Now sometimes we might think, well, Mary is very different from us. You know, we have the Immaculate Conception, and at the end of her life she was assumed into heaven. But you know, the things that happen to Mary also happen to us as well. They're gifts of God to us. It just happens a little differently. Mary was conceived without sin from the moment of her conception. But we are freed from sin at our baptism. So everybody who is baptized has that same immaculate quality, that same pure quality that Mary had from the very beginning. And at the end of our life, Mary is assumed into heaven. And we pray that we too, at the end of our life, will be taken up to heaven at the end of time, so that we can be happy with God forever. So Mary is kind of for us a great model of one who understood what God was doing in her life, and also who then acted on that, so that when the Lord asks us, will you do this special thing for me? We will be able to say, just like Mary did, I am a servant of the Lord. I will do as the Lord asks. Because the Lord is with us, so we don't have to be afraid, because nothing is impossible with God.